Here's how this works. I'm gonna read some real jokes, really submitted by my writers, that are unusable for the show. Some are dumb, some are offensive, some are just insane. Most importantly, the writers don't know we're doing this, and because a lot of them don't watch the show, they'll never know. So let's get started. Today was National Peanut Butter Day. Yeah, I'm not falling for that again, said your dog. Mike Scollins wrote that joke. That's him. You know how we know? He put his name on it. He wanted us to know, like a serial killer who left a note. Scotland celebrated Burns Supper yesterday, which honors the life of poet Robert Burns. Meanwhile, single dads celebrate Burns Supper whenever it's their weekend with the kids. Brian wrote that joke. He's got a kid and, you know. I think he's doing all right feeding her, I don't know. A 79-year-old man in Australia recently set the Guinness World Record for oldest competitive soccer player. Said the announcer, "Old." Where's Ian, you guys? A loose wallaby was recently seen hopping through a field of snow in England, and a wallaby, of course, is how the British say little boy. Even now, I have no idea what that means. Literally just a collection of words that seem to have no relation to one another. Karen Chi wrote that joke. You might guess from your picture, and you'd be right. This is a person with nothing but joy in her heart, and yet that joke made me so mad at her. That's probably the look she had on her face the whole time she wrote it. She didn't know. Wallaby. Wallaby is how the British say little boy. I'll say it in a British accent. Let's see if it sounds like wallaby. Wallaby. Oh, it does. New Hampshire Governor Chris Sununu said in an interview that he's considering running for president. He thinks the country needs Sununu voice. So that's a play on a new voice. If his name was Governor Anunu, it's still bad, but you understand it. Sununu, you don't. That was written by Matt Goldich. And he's here and probably brokenhearted that he didn't get any applause. All right, guys, he wrote the next one too, and I want to encourage you. If you just want to start booing as loud as you can. Because I think that's the only way we can affect their behavior. They gotta be publicly shamed. He's here now. This is your chance to put a stop to this. Because I know you're not gonna be here tomorrow, but I am. And he is. And I can't stop him. Pepsi has announced it will no longer offer Sierra Mist soda. Oh no, then how will I make my famous Sierra Mistu? Boo! Imagine how broken your brain has to be. Yeah. You see Sierra Mist on a piece of paper. And you think to yourself, oh, I know what my boss who tells joke in front of human beings will like. Also, somebody in graphics had to make a Sierra Mistu. Like, they had real work to do. Man, they had to go to a real school, not like the writers on this show. We just found milling around. Prince Harry sat down for an interview last night on 60 Minutes with Anderson Cooper. Yeah, you know what? I'm not ready for this one yet, Wally. I don't know if I'm ever gonna be ready. Today was former Vice President Dick Cheney's 82nd birthday, and if you wanna know what he's getting, the heart intended for your grandma. Scollins. Today was National Opposite Day, and my coworkers are not gonna like how I use the urinal. Just be happy we stayed with that graphic. Oh yeah, it's Scollins again. This is a third Scollins in a row. A second library in Colorado has been forced to close due to crystal meth contamination. Why? That's how we got some of our best books. We have no proof. Seuss was on crystal. Today was World Hypnotism Day, and thank God it's almost over because I am not enjoying being a duck stuck at the bottom of a well. Quack, for the love of God, won't somebody stop? Allie wrote that one. There's Allie. Very nice lady who's obviously having a bad run of things. Netflix announced last week that it has renewed the show Wednesday for a second season, adding, but here's the thing. Okay. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, you know, there's at least there's some craft there. I'm setting this down so I don't put it through my eye after telling the punchline. According to new reports, a sequel to the 2004 movie The Passion of the Christ will begin shooting this spring. And needless to say, it's a crossover. Ian wrote that joke, and in case you're wondering who to hit with the lightning bolt. All right. I'm gonna tell it now. Are you guys sure? Are you sure? Because on a few of these, you kind of showed you don't have the intestinal fortitude for what we're doing here. So just remember, when I tell this punchline, you asked for it. Is this the last one? Okay. That's good to know. Because I feel like it might be a little hard to follow. Prince Harry sat down for an interview last night on 60 Minutes with Anderson Cooper while your mom sat down in a puddle. You guys! Bays wrote it. And he died right after he wrote it. You didn't even have a heart to laugh at it. He wrote it, and it was so funny he died. And then not one of you laughed. There's the real Bays. Let's look at the real Bays. There he is. You guys, this has been a surprise inspection.
Authorities in Philadelphia recently picked up two goats that were spotted walking through a neighborhood. I'd tell you what the goats said when they were arrested, but we'd have to bleat it out. A young man named Ian wrote that joke. He looks like this. Did you get it? President Biden is set to meet tomorrow with the Italian Prime Minister, where they will discuss the concerning rise of Antipa. So, that joke is about Antifa and antipasto. I forget who wrote it. Can we take a look? We're off and running. Researchers at MIT published a study this week that details the best way to split an Oreo And this was pretty surprising. It's with your butt cheeks. Like, so somebody we pay money to. Says, like, at a computer, and they're like, okay. I'll show this to my boss. Let's take a look at Matt. Matt wrote that. There you go. Oh. Today was Manatee Appreciation Day, so give them some props. Kind of miss the butt cheeks a little bit. Kind of remember in the good old days of the butt cheek Oreos. Brian wrote that. A couple in Massachusetts was recently awarded nearly $5 million in a lawsuit against a local country club after enduring years of golf balls crashing into their home. This after the club only offered them four. So that joke required you to remember that they settled for $5 million. And then the whole joke, and then it got to four. And that was, hey, you know what? That was Brian. Why don't we give him some props? Yeah. Authorities in Florida recently arrested a man who allegedly stole a crossbow from a store by stuffing it down his pants. That or his penis can shoot arrows. Karen! That or his penis can shoot arrows. I don't know. I don't think it makes any sense. You don't understand! The worst is the poor man whose penis shoots arrows. His wife's like, will you stop by the sporting goods store? He's like, you know, every time I go in there, they think I'm stealing a crossbow. According to a new study, having a long-term pet may delay memory loss, though the brain-eating parasite in your cat's poop may have other plans. That was from Allie. There's Allie. There she seems very... Now, if you've been watching our show for any amount of time, first of all, second of all, you know that the worst offender on our writing staff when it comes to writing terrible, unusable, monstrous jokes is our writer, Mike Scollins. Let's take a look at Mike. There he is. Nope, that's Allie. And that's Mike right there. He once wore a tank top to work. So, the thing about Mike is he writes really good jokes. He's a very good joke writer, but he has no middle ground. They are either monologue worthy or absolute shocking garbage. So let's just turn the spotlight on Mike for a few jokes here. I'll get through them as fast as I can so it won't hurt that much. Russian forces have reportedly placed trained dolphins at the entrance to a port on the Black Sea to protect a naval base, and they're still happier than the ones at SeaWorld. A man from Illinois has gained attention online after he claims to have found a 60-year-old McDonald's meal behind his bathroom wall. Also, Grimace. Oh, pretty good. I mean, that's pretty good. We could have done that one. You know what? I will say, like, this is also, like, there's a poor graphics department that, like, Mike writes these terrible things and then they gotta go, like, that's their job today. It's like, well, we gotta put the skeleton of Grimace in a wall. Netflix announced yesterday it will develop 5 new shows for preschoolers based on famous Dr. Seuss books, but you're not gonna like who's directing Hop on Pop, guys. He's right, they weren't gonna like it. The Tony Award nominees were announced yesterday in the musical MJ about the late singer Michael Jackson. So, guys, let's just prepare ourselves. Okay? The Tony Award nominees were announced yesterday in the musical MJ about the late singer Michael Jackson, because I think we should be able to jump ahead and be like, which part of Michael Jackson? What's the joke? The Tony Award nominees were announced yesterday, and the musical MJ about the late singer Michael Jackson received 10 nominations. Well, it is supposed to be touching. Mike Scollins, beat it. This has been Surprise Inspection. According to a new book, former President Trump once tried to exchange an attorney's $2 million legal fees with the deed to a horse, which he says was, quote, something more valuable. For his part, Trump swore it would be a win-winnie. That's not even a dad joke. It's like a deadbeat dad joke. It's like a dad who doesn't even want to put in the effort. Ian wrote that joke. That's what Ian looks like, so. Win-winnie. A pair of dentures that belong to baseball legend Ty Cobb are up for auction, which is exciting because the dentures were originally thought to be flossed. So what our writer there, believe it or not, Ian, did there was he used flossed for lost. That was, in case you were confused, which I was when I read it, because I don't think anybody thinks of lost and flossed as words that are interchangeable. That would, like, be me saying that Ian is a huge floozer. The Senate yesterday ratified Finland and Sweden's application to join NATO in a 95-1 vote because we can't afford not to have them on our side. So this is interesting. Before you clap, and I have to ask you to leave. So I actually thought when I read that joke, oh, that's clever, but I thought fjords were sort of unique amongst the Scandinavian countries to Norway. But I thought, well, I'll just Google real quick and make sure that they're also in Finland and Sweden, and they're not. But you can't let geography get in the way of an A-plus joke. Singer, oh, that was Matt, by the way, wrote that joke. And he's actually standing right over there as well, so. Do you clap when you see somebody steal a lady's purse? Take the lights down on the audience. Singer Taylor Swift recently announced that she will release a new album next month. Guys, just wait a second. Also, that reflects badly on Taylor Swift since you just applauded for Matt. Nobody thinks you guys now have, like, high standards for who you like. Singer Taylor Swift recently announced that she will release a new album next month called Midnights, which is, quote, the stories of 13 sleepless nights scattered throughout my life. So whatever you do, skip the song titled Chipotle. Scientists at NASA recently reported that algae in a Washington State canal is visible from space. Also, yo mama. At least it's written in my voice. That was, if you've watched the show, you won't be surprised that was written by Mike Scollins. There's Mike right there. And we use that photo of Scollins because one time he wore a tank top to work and everybody here, you know, roasted him for it. But I'm a little ashamed about this. I have a confession to make. The picture that we've been using of him in a tank top is photoshopped. So as a peace offering to Scollins, let's put up the original photo. There it is. Okay. Back to the inspection. A woman in Minnesota recently went skydiving to celebrate her 91st birthday. Unfortunately, before she could open her parachute, her boobs had already landed. During a press briefing this week, White House Coronavirus Response Coordinator Dr. Ashish Jha encouraged people to get vaccinated against the coronavirus and the flu at the same time and said, quote, "This is why God gave us two arms. Guess you'll just have to choose one or the other. Guy who killed Dr. Richard Kimball's wife?" Does it change your mind that your hero wrote it? That's it. We're never allowing the writers to be in the room again for surprise inspection. Oh. Britain's Queen Elizabeth formally appointed Liz Truss as prime minister today at her castle in Scotland. When asked about her plans as prime minister, she replied, "Trust me." Now, obviously, there are a lot of problems with that joke, including the fact that we wrote a Queen Elizabeth joke before she passed away. And then we still chose to tell it in surprise inspection. And I think based on how these jokes go, when you heard Queen Elizabeth, you probably all tensed up and thought that maybe it would be an inappropriate joke about our departed monarch. But it wasn't. It was just a joke written before she died. But if you remember her at all, let it be from that joke. She'd want that. Trust me. Do you think that joke is maybe what? No. No. Today was actor Kevin Spacey's 63rd birthday. He blew the candles and then, nope, I'm not doing that. All right, this has been Surprise Inspection.